Dear friends, today I have a question on Gauss's law, and the question is from Bhavdeep Vamza. Hello sir, my name is Bhavdeep and I am from Gujarat, Amreli. Sir, in Gauss law we say that we can take any Gaussian surface and also say that in the equation E dot ds equal to Q by epsilon naught, the right side term Q is the charge inside the Gaussian surface and the left side term E is resultant electric field. Sir, now here is the problem. Sir, how can we find electric field at any point without taking all the charges? So that's the basic question, that on the right side we take only the charge inside the Gaussian surface and claim that the electric field that we obtain from here is from all the charges present. So that's the basic question, that how can we find electric field at any point without taking all the charges in consideration? So that is the question. Now, to understand this, the Gauss's law is not about the electric field at one point. It is about the flux of the electric field on a closed surface in the form that we study. There is another form of Gauss's law which talks point to point electric field also, but forget that. So our Gauss's law is written as integration of E dot ds. There is a circle out here, so it's a closed surface, and this is equal to Q inside and divided by epsilon naught. And then, yes, very good, this is charge inside the Gaussian surface which is a closed surface, remember. And this is the resultant electric field. This is the resultant electric field due to all the charges present anywhere inside or outside. But it is not telling you what is the electric field at a certain point. You have a closed surface, this is a closed surface, and here is a point on the closed surface, and you construct a small area here, call that as ds. This is your ds area, this is your ds area, and the electric field at this point is this E. But then you have to do this E dot ds, add for all such elements on the surface, then you get the left hand side. So it is not giving you the electric field at this point. It is giving you the sum of, integration of all such electric field dot ds, electric field dot ds, electric field dot ds, electric field dot ds. And that flux happens to be equal to the charge inside only these charges, which are sitting somewhere inside some Q1, Q2, but there are charges Q3, Q4. There are charges like this, and this electric field that we are talking is because of all these charges, this plus this plus this. It's claimed that it's the resultant electric field of all. Why? Because if you take an outside charge, suppose this charge, and only because of this, how much is the electric field here? Only because of this, how much the electric field is here? And that electric field, if you use in the left hand side, that will be zero. That will be zero. Because if you take, it's a closed surface, remember, if you have an element here, then you also have elements somewhere here, somewhere here. It crosses. So the E dot ds is positive here, or negative here, E dot ds is of opposite sign here. So this total flux because of these charges is zero, and therefore only the inside charges will give you this flux is equal to inside charges divided by epsilon naught. So that is the story. So be very confident. This is the electric field due to all the charges present, and this is the charge only inside, and still it works. So now the question arises that how do we apply Gauss's law and get the electric field at a certain point due to a charge distribution? But you cannot do it always in all conditions. For example, suppose you want electric field due to this charge, single charge, this charge only. There's no other charge. Then the Gauss law is fine. The field here will be decided by this length Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and then R square. And field here will be different because it will be different R. The distance is now different. So using Gauss's law, you cannot get what is the electric field here, what is the electric field here, but the Gauss's law is still true. So Gauss's law can be applied, and you can get electric field at a certain point only for certain symmetric charge distribution. Example, one of the examples that you do, a spherical charge distribution with constant uniform charge density. So if you are looking for that, you have a sphere, and in that sphere it's a uniformly charged, the charge density is rho everywhere, and then you want to find the electric field at this point. There are no other charges, given that there are no other charges. Then you say that, okay, let us make another concentric sphere, and then on that sphere we take a certain point, and here at this point the electric field E, and then you say that the electric field must be in this direction, ds is also in this direction, so integration of E dot ds, it's same as E ds cos theta, which is equal to E ds. And now you apply the symmetry that since this point and this point and this point and this point, they are equivalent as far as this is concerned. You cannot distinguish this point with that point and that point with this point apart from the direction. So the magnitude of electric field here must be same as here, must be same as here, same as here. And therefore you take this E out, and then you can get that electric field. This is E ds. Now this E is unique. This E is unique, and then you do all kinds of calculations, E times 4 pi epsilon naught R square and so on. And from there you get the electric field here. See, you get point by point electric field only if there is a symmetry in the charge distribution, and you use that. You use that, then you can get point by point electric field. Otherwise, Gauss's law is valid in all conditions.